We're glad that you're interested in applying to the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee, also called UWM. Applying to UWM is easy and straightforward. This video will show you how to apply online. Depending on your answers to the questions in this application, the screens you see might vary slightly from what you see here. For this demonstration, we are going to show you what it looks like for an international student to apply to UWM to be a new first-year student, or freshman. You should be able to complete your own application based on our example. You will see a question mark inside of a circle next to some questions on the application. You can always click on the question mark for more information about how to answer that question. If you have any questions, please let us know. At the end of the video, you will find helpful links and email addresses. Please feel free to contact us for additional advice. Begin on the page University of Wisconsin Online Application User Registration. You can find this at https://apply.wisconsin.edu. If you haven't yet registered for the site, click the button Register as a New User. If you already registered on the site, use your login and password to enter your account. Keep your login and password in a safe place so that you can access our online application portal as needed. You do not need to complete your entire application in one sitting. After you've logged into your account, click Create a New Application. From the drop-down menu, select UW-Milwaukee. Are you a U.S. citizen? You will likely select No to this question, since you are applying as an international student. This question helps us identify your current status in the U.S. If you are outside the U.S. and need to apply for a student visa, select Need to apply for student visa, not residing in the U.S. If you are currently in the U.S. on a visa, select Current visa holder, residing in the U.S. If your situation is different, please select the option that seems most appropriate for your circumstances. The option for international student applying to an online program is only for students who will study entirely online and will not come to the U.S. If you plan to come to the USA to study at UWM, do not choose this option. The next question asks whether you have completed high school, secondary school, or the equivalent. If you are currently studying in secondary school and will graduate before coming to UWM, select Not Yet Completed. If you have already completed secondary school, select Already Graduated. Post-secondary education refers to the university-level coursework you might have completed. Please select whatever seems most appropriate for your situation. We now ask your reason for applying. We want you to share why you want to come to UWM. Undergraduate degree is for students who want to complete a bachelor's degree at UWM. Undergraduate courses as a visitor or guest student is for applicants who want to take courses at UWM but do not want to complete a degree. Please note that UWM is unable to sponsor student visas for visitor or guest students. The ESL option is for students who want to come to UWM and study English as a second language only, and will not register for any academic courses. If you are applying for conditional admission, which means that your admission to UWM will be pending based upon completion of language requirements, please select undergraduate degree. The final option, non-degree exchange students, is only to be selected by those coming from a partner institution. If you are not sure if this applies to you, please do not select it. On this screen, you will identify your intended major or field of study. This is your area of academic interest. If you have not yet decided, check the Undecided box. If you have an interest in a pre-professional program, such as law or medicine, check the Appropriate box in the Pre-Professional Program section. In the Program section, you can search by program name, subject area, or school or college. Then select the area or areas that interest you. As you can see, UWM offers many academic fields. Pre-professional programs are optional and are not majors. These programs are designed to prepare you for a professional degree program after your bachelor's degree. On this screen, you will select whether you are applying as a new freshman or another option. If you have completed any university-level courses, please select Transfer. If you have studied somewhere else, you must report it. You will select whether you are applying for the fall term, September through December, or the spring term, January through May. This question determines when you would like to start your studies at UWM. This page shows the summary of all of the answers you have given on the previous screens. Review this page carefully to determine that you have correctly answered the questions. Now you will complete the personal information pages. You will need to answer these questions fully. Be sure to write your name exactly the same as it appears on your passport. If your name is written differently on any part of your application, please be sure to include that name here. For example, if your name on your transcript is not the same as your name on your passport, here is where you can provide the alternate name. If you have never lived or worked in the U.S., it is likely you do not have a U.S. Social Security number. You can leave this blank and check the box, "I do not have or do not wish to provide a Social Security number." Please complete the questions that ask for your gender, male or female, place of birth, and country of citizenship. For the question regarding your U.S. status and visa type, if you need a visa to come to UWM and you are not sure which type, please select F1. Please indicate your native language. Then you will complete a page with your email and mailing addresses. Make sure that you put in all information accurately so that we can contact you without difficulty. If you intend to request a student visa, F1 or J1, you must provide a permanent foreign, non-US address with a street name. If your mailing address is different from your permanent home address, please provide a separate mailing address. You only need to fill in the boxes that apply to your address. Please also complete your telephone number so that we may contact you if necessary. Now we would like to know about your previous education. Please complete all of these sections with the information we have requested. We ask that you report fully all institutions in which you've studied. On this screen, we ask about your English language proficiency. Please indicate whether you have taken the TOEFL, Test of English as a Foreign Language, and/or the IELTS, International English Language Testing System. Please report the date you took the exam and your score. Please report your scores from any standardized tests you have taken. If you are a new freshman applying to any programs or majors in the College of Engineering and Applied Science, you will also need to submit official score reports for the ACT or SAT. If you have previously attended any higher education institutions, in either the U.S. or another country, please list that information on this page. Higher education refers to anything beyond high school or secondary school. If you have not attended a higher education institution in the past, simply check the box next to "I have no institutions of higher education to report." Are you currently enrolled in or officially registered for any post-secondary courses? Please check yes if you are enrolled in a post-secondary course. Check no if you are not or if you are not sure. In this section, we want to learn about your educational history. You will answer yes or no to the first section. If you answer no, you will move on to the next section. If you answer yes, that a gap does exist in your educational history from grade 9 to the present, please explain what you were doing during that time. Examples may include working, traveling, or completing military service. We'd like to know what you enjoy doing outside of the classroom. Do you play sports, play an instrument, participate in community service activities, volunteer in your community, or work a part-time job? In this section, we'd like you to explain the activities you enjoy. You may add as many activities as you want. You may also write a short essay about the activity that is most important to you. In 50 to 100 words, you can explain your most important activity. This will help us to learn more about you. If you don't have any activities to report, check the box at the bottom of the screen. This section is a chance for you to tell us more about yourself. Is there anything you would like us to know that has not been reported in another part of this application? Be sure to save your statements frequently so that you don't lose the work you have done. It is important that your statement be original and written by you. Please do not copy the work of another writer. This page asks you some campus-specific questions, such as, are you currently enrolled at or have you previously attended UW-Milwaukee? You will likely check no for this question. Then you will see the answers to a few questions you previously answered. Please confirm that your answers are correct. We would like to know if you are planning on living on campus. Please note that all new UWM freshmen are required to live on campus for the first year. We also strongly encourage new transfer and graduate students to live on campus for at least the first year as well. We are interested in how you first learned about UWM. This page addresses your current residency for determining tuition. We've already established that you are not a resident of the state of Wisconsin, so you simply need to check Next. You are almost ready to submit your application. You should click Perform Final Check for Errors to run a final and complete check for application errors. You have made it to this screen, which shows that your application does not have any recognizable errors. You will need to sign and date your application electronically. You can then submit your application for review. Be sure to read the information carefully. Note that by submitting your application, you agree that all application materials given to UWM become the property of the University of Wisconsin system. Please do not send us transcripts that cannot be replaced. Once your application is submitted, you will not be able to modify your application. If you realize you need to make a change and it has already been submitted, please email us the new information. Once you have submitted your online application, you will need to pay the application and evaluation fees. The easiest way to do this is online, using a credit card through this screen. The non-refundable application fee is $44 if you are applying to a degree program. The $44 application fee is not required for applicants who are currently attending a UW system two-year college. An additional $40 evaluation fee is required of applicants with secondary and or university-level transfer work from non-U.S. colleges or universities to cover the cost of processing and evaluating non-U.S. credentials. Congratulations! You have successfully completed your online application for admission to UW-Milwaukee. Once you have submitted the necessary credentials, our admission counselors will review your application and contact you shortly with an admission decision. Within a few business days of submitting your application online, you will receive an email from iss@uwm.edu with information on how to check the status of your application online using your PAWS account. The online account will include a list of items that you need to submit in order to complete your application. If you have any questions, please email us at iss@uwm.edu. We hope to welcome you to UWM in the future.